This is going to be a quick introduction into some of the DX9 shapes we can create in VVVV. I'll be showing you the quad, the pillow, the segment and the rope. I already have set this up and I also created a renderer. Okay, let's make a group node so we can show all four shapes in the renderer. Group EX9. Use head inspector to change the layer count to 4. And connect every object to the group. Every object to another pin, of course. Connect the group to the renderer. When I connect the group to the renderer, you see a white square, but that is because they are all rendered on top of each other. So to fix this, we're going to make a transform node. 2D. I could make 4 transform nodes, but we just make 1. I want to create a spread with 4 slices and send every individual slice of that spread to a different object. So first I make a circular spread. You guessed it, we're going to put them in a circle. Output X to translate X, output I to translate I. And we set the spread count to 4. And now I need a get slice to send every individual slice to the individual object. So I double left click, type in get slice. Everything that is not a value, a string or a color can be dealt with the node group. So transforms, textures and all other stuff can be manipulated by picking the node category. Okay, I need 4 of these get slice nodes, so I just select the first one, hit Ctrl D to duplicate, replace it, hit Ctrl D again and again. Next, I want to connect the transform to every individual get slice node. So I right click, left click, left click, left click, left click, right click. Connect every get slice to its objects, the quad, the pillow, the segment, and the rope. A get slice node lets you select what slice of the spread you want to use. Start counting with 0. So for the quad, I want to use 0. So for the pillow, I want to use the second slice, that's slice number 1, the third slice, or slice number 2, and the fourth slice, or slice number 3. Well, you don't see the rope yet, but we are going to fix that later. Let's make the scale a bit smaller. Perhaps the width and the height a bit different. When doing something with graphics on your computer, a good advice is to keep everything as light as possible. And especially goes with VVV because it's real time. Every object you see here is just built from a number of rendered triangles or polygons, and it should be your mission to keep the polygon count as low as you can. The quad, as you see here, is the most basic of shapes, and in the previous tutorials I've showed you how to move it around, rotate it or give it a color. Now, the interesting part and the real useful part is when you apply a texture to it. Texture can be a video, a color gradient, a picture, or even a complete renderer. And I will show you all that in the next tutorial. But for a quick look, let's make a file texture. I connect it to the texture pin of the quad. And now when I right-click here on file name, I can load a picture. In the VVVV Girl Power folder, there is a folder called Images, and in there is a picture of our planet. So I just double click and you see the picture of the Earth is on the quad now. Everything I do with the transform of this quad will also happen to this picture. So if I change the face pin of the circular spread, you see that the Earth moves nicely along with the quad. Okay, the next object, a pillow. This is just like a quad, but only it has some faded edges. I can change the fade amount. Or I can change the edges, not round, round, not round. I know this looks awesome for some purposes, but this node also got 4 or 8 polygons more than the quad. To show the polygons of an object, I can connect a fill node. So I double left click, type in fill and pick fill render state. And now I can connect this fill to the quad pillow segment and rope. So I right click, the render state pin. And if I hover above the fill mode pin and I right click, you see the 3 states. It's point, wireframe and solid. Solid is the default as you see right now. But if I select wireframe, we can see the polygons. So as you see, the pillow has got a lot more polygons than the quad has. Okay, let's change the fill back to solid. The pillow uses 2 colors. the fill color and the fade color. Now, when I hover above the fade color pin, you see A equals 0%. The A is the alpha value, or the transparency. I will be handling colors in a later tutorial. So if I connect the file texture to the pillow, the picture got a faded, blurry edge, which can be very interesting and useful. Okay, the segment. We can use this one to get a circle-like shape. So when I fiddle around with the resolution pin, you will see my segment is transforming into a circle. And if I bring it all down, I get a triangle shape. Or if I move it all up, I get a nice circle again. I can also change the inner radius to get a donut-like shape. And when I play with the cycles pin, I can get this Pac-Man-like shape. Okay, let's reset this. One cycle. No, inner radius. When I change the fill mode to wireframe, you can see all the different polygons. And you might see why it's not the best idea to use a resolution of 1000. Because now you ask VVV to render 1000 extra polygons for you. A lower resolution, like 32, will also produce a nice circle. The resolution is not for the amount of polygons or triangles, but for the amount of corner pins. So if I put the resolution to 4, I get this triangle. It has 3 sides. But if I change the fill mode to point, it might be a bit hard to see, but I get 4 points now, and that's what the resolution does. Okay, I put this back to solid. The coloring of a segment is something to keep in mind. Every color I input here is used to draw one polygon and not, unlike the quad, for the entire shape. If you select the segment and press Alt F1, you go to the VVVV website to the help page of the segment node, and there you can download a patch that shows you how to color a segment. Let's make it round again. Now, if I was to connect this file texture to the segment, I need to change the way the texture is projected onto the segment. And I can set this in the texture coordinate mapping here. I right click and I think I need to choose front projected. Okay, onto the rope node. The rope node draws a line from point A to point B. And you can give the points here with the X and I pins. To show you this, I need to feed the rope with more than one value. So I make an IO box, put the slice count mode to Colesgrove pages, make it 2 rows, make the node a bit bigger, select it, hit Ctrl D, and now I got 2 of these. Connect one to the X pin and the other one to the I pin. Now let's change some values. As you can see, the rope is growing from point A, XI, to point B. So from the first slice to the second slice. Because I have transformed the entire rope, the X and I values do not represent the actual X and I axis of your renderer. To show you that, I will delete the connection of the transform, and then I connect the rope straight to the renderer. And now my X and I values match the X and I positions inside the renderer. The rope is a bit complex and you need to know how to handle spreads and spread sequences before you can make maximal use of this. I can also change the rope thickness or its color, but for now I leave you with this. If you select the rope and press F1, you will see the help file and you will see other amazing things you can do with the rope. In my next tutorial, I'm finally going to show you a bit more about colors in VVVV.